Hello, all you wonderful people. Welcome to my basement. Yes, okay, I'll make the basement. I know. I wanted to be done with this project, but you guys really want the basement? Okay, I do a little MTV Cribs thing. I've never seen MTV Cribs in my life, but I'm pretty sure it's like, and then you're like, whoa, look at this storage closet. Look at this other one. Oh my God, so amazing. We got a wonderful area here. Looks great. Awesome central hallways. Look at this amazing brewing section. So gorgeous. Look at that hallway section. You can totally do whatever you want in this thing. So, you know what I'm gonna do? Also, really sexy nether portal. I'm gonna make this thing, but I'm gonna let you choose what you want it to look like. You know what I mean. What's wrong with this? This isn't sunken in. Oh, yeah, okay. So, it's all up to you. And, you know, we have hallways. You can have this huge hallway or you can have a tiny hallway. I'll give you the tools necessary to make it because I can't appeal to everybody. Can't please everybody. I just mix both of those words together. So, how do you get down here? It's off to the right. Aquí. Right there. And we're going to head over to our Castle Manor momentarily. I just gotta make sure I have the dimensions right, and we'll grab this thing here. We have not touched the basement in several weeks, actually, and I'm hoping that this will be the last episode that I need to do, aside from maybe a little bit from the front. I did tell you guys to do your own thing here. So when you walk in, you're gonna turn to your left and we're gonna go down this hall. As you can see, here we are. Break this out completely. And we're going to take out these blocks and we're just gonna make a staircase that goes all the way down here. Make sure that you're actually going down. So we have that. And you just kinda walk in. You can have fences here. That's kinda what I'm gonna have in my basement. That's what I would want. You know, you just walk in. You can have, what we can do is we can have a fence gate and have it nice and neat. So it's not always bugging you. And we're going to have two stairs like that. And maybe we'll have a half slab. Like so. So that kind of looks nice. And you walk in. Boom. Close it behind you. Here we are. Here we go. Let's try and remember what the flipping thing looked like. Okay, let's figure this out. Okay, can't break that. Nope. I should probably actually study whatever I'm doing. Because, for some reason, the nether portal is two blocks, but this hallway's three blocks. I'm gonna go take a look at the basement. I'll get right back to you. Boop. I remember now. It's very simple. So, I'm assuming that you guys already have this foundation right here because I will not be able to tell you where to get it. But what I can tell you is that I forgot. Crap! I totally just connected both of these basements by a, a little tunnel thing, and I learned that you need to have a little bit more space. So, as you can see, there are three blocks here. You need to have four blocks. So, yay. This explains why everything was not lining up. So, one more extra thing right there. Let's just break this out. This is going to be really fun. Like, really fun for all of you to break out an extra layer of dirt. So, what I'll do is I'll pause and I'll get rid of it. And I will see you in a second. So, now that we painstakingly removed an extra layer, so that we have four blocks of height rather than three now. Let's just make sure that these blocks right here are perfect because this is what we're going to be basing the entire basement on. You know how you find one focal point, like the center block, and you base everything off of it? This is that. That is exactly what this is. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna divide this thing real quick. It's gonna be very easy now that I've studied it. It's just based off a little, you know, let's remove these things for so you don't confuse yourself. We're gonna have a two wide hallway going all the way down here. As you can see, we have the other place for reference. All you're gonna do is, after you've made your stairway, which is based off of this, starting on this block and going down several blocks, four blocks of height, if you did that correctly, all you have to do is place these blocks like that, place one, and then do a space of two, a space of two, a space of three, space of two, space of two. And you now can create your own basement to look whatever you want. Because now we have a grid, something to work with. We have the center, and we have, you know, our X and Y. So what I'm going to do, specifically me, is I'm going to set up little tiny areas for storage because I have a ton of cobble after making this thing, ton of dirt. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, and there are multitudes of things that you can do. You can't do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place two blocks like that. So we got that. Let's replace this, take that out, right? And we will then make a block right here, pillar right there. So it's symmetrical right here. So now what you can do is you can decorate this however you want. You can remove these blocks and you can totally do any type of design that makes you happy. What is that? So, you know, one way you could do is keep that warm color scheme from upstairs. You can do a cold color scheme just by, you know, making this all gray. Or you can kind of do more like that. You place these here and then just spruce planks going up because this is going to be covered in whatever you put. So, we have that. Next, for the in-between each thing, you're going to place stairs like that. Toggle downfall. Okay. So we have stairs, and that's creating arches, and they look really nice. And we got that. And that's just going to be our thing. We're just going to place these arches everywhere. Like on everything. Everything and everywhere will have these awesome arches. This is where the infamous, or not the infamous, the super famous nether portal room was. So it's just across the hall from here, and we're going to do the same exact thing that we did on the other side. So you're just going to place blocks right here. Take this out. Just place a block in the middle. So now we have our template. What I'm going to do is I'm going to remove these blocks in the outline of a standard nether portal. Get some obsidian. Where is that? I'll just search for it. We got obsidian. And we'll just place it in the outline of it. You don't need to do the corners. And we'll get ourselves a flint and steel. And okay, we got it. So we'll just place an arch right there. More arches here. Arches here. Arches there. So what I did on the other build. Oh, look, a secret portal. So this is what I mean by customize. Instead of having the pillars here, I removed one. And I kept, I took the pillar from the middle out so that I would have space for a potion area. And you can do the same thing on this side. You can do anything. So I'm just giving you the template, remember that. And you can choose whatever you want to do. I'm just going to give you an example. And one way to do it, there are many ways to do it. And they all look great. There is something wrong with me, very wrong with me today. One thing I'm changing is I'm taking that last part of the blocks right here, changing that to stone. Just looks nicer. So to do I need a break. That's what I need. The potion brewing area. It's basically this. Take this out, take all these out, and we just fill in the entirety of this with this spruce stuff. Yeah? And then we'll get a half slab. I'll just place those there. One second. I gotta do it. I gotta do it. Gotta fill it in. We'll get a half slab. Half slab. Half stone slab. Where are you? Where are you, stone slab? Right here. And we'll just place them right here and here. And then what we'll do is we'll create a little stand you can do of any material. I'm just doing this because it's there. And you get your potion brewing stuff. And you place a ton on. A ton of them. And here you go. Like that. So what you should do at this point, you know, you have all these fancy walls and stuff, and they look great. And you're just filling it in, going around, and just adding all your stuff, moving in. Make sure you do the floor. I don't really have a fancy floor for this because that'd just be expensive. I chose oak because it just feels right, you know? Where's my oak? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to not cheat. And I'm just going to grab that. And I'm going to go over here. Don't fill in the floor if you're going to lower the floor. If not, then it's perfectly fine. And we'll just do set planks. There you go. So we have that. Set our planks. You know, and just go around filling stuff in that you think needs to be filled in. I don't think you do much here. If you really want to, you can put something there so it doesn't show. I'm not gonna do anything crazy. Just gonna, I don't know. Let me see. Let's do that. Something like this. So you walk down. It's not obstructing anything. So now that we have this, right, you're gonna want different hallways and stuff. So one way that I did it was I just had these going across. Let me see if it works. Let me see if this works. You can almost hear my brother screaming. So what we're going to do, what I'm going to do, is I'm going to do a space of one, and then I'm going to put a block, and then I'm going to put space of two all the way to the end, and we're going to do this. So if you were mimicking the first floor in the fact that it kind of has an indent, this is where you would put that indent. If you wanted to have more space to do fun stuff, like another basement, this is where you would put it. You'd put it on the left right here, and it would just go down like that. So, infinite staircase. You just do it. Just do it. And we're just going to go around. I'm going to place a pillar right here. And then I'm just going to copy over this set of pillars like so. And we're going to get our stairs, and we're just going to connect everything. Every little bit needs to be connected with stairs. So pretty. Right here, right here. No, like that. There we go. So we have a beautiful hallway, and you can totally put chests here if you want. That's your thing. Be sure to decorate. I already had chests in my inventory. If you saw the other version, I do suggest also putting stuff behind here. I'm just showing you all the little things you can do. Like so. And we have that staircase if you want it. If you want to cover this up, you're going to put upside down stairs like so all the way up. So it covers that part up. We can go to the other side. We'll place another thing like so. Going up, blocking it off. Let's see, maybe we need a furnace area. That's something we also need here. And if you wanted to, you can block some of this off, like so, like doing this, so that it's not just like, it's not just too open. It forces you to walk around for a little bit, which I think is a fun thing. We have that. You have to go around here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to remove this stuff, because it's really annoying me, and I'm going to get either stone, so it looks nice, or logs. I think stone would work best. So, just so that I don't have to, like, explode in anger, having to deal with that stupidity. I'm just gonna fill this with stone. Don't break your thingy. All right, we'll head back downstairs. And we will continue the basement. So we have multiple means of egress in here. So we have this blocked off completely. We can do something like this. Maybe. And you have stuff there. Maybe. One thing you can do, instead of blocking it off like that, you can totally just put a spacer, is what I call them. Where it's just a little section right here in the middle between four pillars. So now it looks nice on all sides. You can still put stuff. You're not losing anything. Just outward space. This side, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to add furnaces. Like so. And I think for aesthetic reasons, I'm going to do a little thing like this. And I'll get myself a cobblestone wall. And we're going to place this every other. And then maybe we'll do something like this. And then, you know, just kind of like mimics. You know, something that would actually work. Like a big, big furnace. And we can we'll place some pillars right here. Just off of this. Place some more pillars. And we're still following the grid. If you look at this. You know, we just kind of made this section right here. And we're still just following here. We're just adding stuff, you know, separating it. So I think we should just have one big room right here. I think that would work best. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put a spacer right here. So when you walk in, you're going to turn to your left, space of one. And we're just going to start placing stuff. Oh, my pop filter just decided to have a mind of its own and attack me. Let's get cobblestone back in our inventory, and we'll place cobblestone here and create a spacer. So you walk in here, boom, boom, furnace, yeah. Something like that. Three wide hallways. We'll just place this stuff here. This is where we run into an issue. What would be good is if you made a spacer like this instead. This is the part where you start just spending space for no reason. Let's not put a spacer. That's just getting in the way. What I will do is I'll just keep this as a big room, and I'll block it off right here. And I'll have a door for expansion on this side. Go over here. So let's do a door right here. That'd be nice. Oh, not like that. Oh. Placing this, placing that, coming down, placing this, getting that, putting it. Yay. There's not much we can do about this except place a pillar right here if we wanted to. But we don't. That's not what we want. Unfortunately. I don't know what to do here. Let's just, we'll place that there. I'm just gonna remove this. We'll do that. I'm gonna keep this. Do that. And I'll just have that going across. So it's like a big room. And you have more space here, you know, stuff like this. This is on the other side where the staircase would go. So if you wanted a staircase, you can totally put that there. Totally access this from the other side. What else do we need? Enchanting room. What better place than here? So, that's what I'm gonna do. Maybe we should have just placed that, like, somewhere better. I don't know what to do. Because I'm totally just adding stuff and removing stuff because I'm an idiot. I can't decide for myself. So let's say that this was the center. Maybe. Like that. That would look weird. Let's say this was the center. That would look less weird. And let's say I place a block right here. So, until I figure out what the hell I'm doing, I'm still kind of at a loss. So I'm going to keep this hallway right here because I like it. Pillars are cool. And I'm going to place... we're going to get enchantment table. We're going to place that in between these two pillars. Intersecting. We're going to get ourselves some bookshelves. This is also, you know, why I wanted you guys to make your own thing, because I prioritize different things than you. I like a big room for an enchanting table. Maybe you don't. Maybe you don't care. Doesn't matter. You know, big center room? I like that. Let's remove this. No dirt. In my house. No, stop.
Stop it.
Let's continue to place these arches. And we'll just go around here. Fixing this up. I'm leaving it up to you to do your own flipping what's it called? Your own backgrounds for this. Remove the dirt. Place something nice. You can add little accents right here if you wanted to. You know, if that's your thing. If you like that. I don't know. Maybe, possibly. Kind of, sort of. Let's do that. Why not? So, let's go over here. One thing you could do is almost, you could lower the floor like I did before. But I don't want to do that right now. Not something I'm prioritizing. I'm going to keep this like that. If you wanted to, you could fence this off. For just for aesthetics, it decreases space efficiency, like workflow. But who cares? Who really cares? Because I don't. Okay. We have that. Looking around, I'm not seeing anything out of place necessarily. Everything looks like it belongs here. Like the furnace and other things. Just making sure all these arches are in place. And this will look really nice once you get that. Place regular stairs on top like that. And then replace these like that. And that'll look nice. That won't look ugly. One thing I almost forgot is this. How much can we remove? Can't remove much. So we have that, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to place that there. Or like that. You can do that if you want. You can do that. I forget what I did on the other side. Let's go take a look at what I did on that side. Let me see if it's anywhere near what I chose. Okay, well, I mean, in this basement, I lowered the ceiling. This is what it looks like. Like I said before, you can do whatever you want. But what I want is more usability out of my space, and lowering the floor meant I couldn't have something like this big. So we have that. We still have some time, so I am going to get some cobblestone, and I'm gonna just fix this place up. Place that, and we're just gonna go around, and I wanna see if it looks nice. Because, you know, at first I said I didn't care. Now I'm starting to care because it's looking pretty cool. Let me just fix this up. Yeah, that was missing. That's dirt. That's not spruce. Boop, boop. And boop, boop. Boop, 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 boop. Yay. Just place this there. This is for expansion. Plenty of room for expansion everywhere. Lower the basement, make more stuff, make a mine shaft. Maybe, possibly. That should be actually back one more block if we're going by that spacer rule. I don't care. Don't do that. Maybe don't do it. Maybe. I don't know. Doesn't matter. It's affecting the build from the outside. You can totally tell. It's ugly. Never mind. Filling it in. We'll go on this side. I don't know. I'm not gonna look at that side. fill that in. Get the cobblestone. Spruce planks. Placing it. That's all I'm talking about at this point. All I'm saying is just words. What am I doing at this? I'm very tired. And this is where you would have space for a mine. So you would make like a little 5x5 room. No, you wouldn't. You would just make a stairway going down. So you, the builder, would make a staircase that would go down all the way, and then you would have a delicious door. Actually, you would as the builder space it out like that. And we'll get a door. Place it there. Beautiful. Yay. Fill in with, let's remove this. Oh, that's why we put that there. Okay, that was before we got good at this. Okay. I don't see anything wrong with this. This looks fantastic. We have a pretty simple floor, which you can spiffy up if you wish. That's your thing. If you want that. If you want a spiffy floor. If not, then you are pretty much done with a fantastic basement. Maybe we can recap all the stuff that we did in this mansion. We first episode, we worked on this place. I still don't have a throne. You want a quick throne? Is that what you want? Is that what you think you want? What do you want? If this was 1.8, I would start using other forms, other stones, but I don't, so I would suggest getting some other stones and doing that. But I'll show you how to do it in cobblestone. We're going to place two blocks. And then we're going to place, let's place five blocks right here. Yeah, yeah. Place one block. Place another block. Upside down, right there. And then we're going to get, let's place two blocks right there. And then we're going to place upside down stair. That's rhyming. We'll place block like that, block like that, block like that, block like that. And then block like that, block like that. And that's how I'd have a throne. Like, we'll do that like that. And then we will have cobblestone wall, right? Place it right there. 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 Yeah. So now we have a call. We have a throne. And they walk in. They're like, holy crap, that's an expensive chair. Wow. I totally made that up on the spot. I wasn't even... I didn't plan to have that. I still don't know what you put on this first floor. The secretary's office. So we go to the next floor. And we have a little room right here. Super cute. Go on the left. This is how you get outside. You know, you go through here, dining room, another way to get outside, go through here, your secret bathroom that leads to underneath here, get secrets and stuff like that. Now you climb the staircase up here, go on your left, you have a beautiful bathroom, close that, little city area, go over here, you have your first bedroom, and then your hallway leads to the bathroom again, this bedroom. Tiny bedroom. And you have, on your right, go upstairs, utility closet, and, a bedroom that I did not care to make. Let's see, we have this area. This is my favorite bedroom at this point. I love it. You can turn this into a closet for the master bedroom. And you can do a few things, maybe. This leads outside. See all the other builds, stuff like that. Let's make sure that the attic looks good before I end it forever. And you come up, and this is when I was explained that I don't want to do the attic, and you can do the attic, and that's what you decide to do. I did the basement. Don't ask for the attic. I think this is pretty much it. We have an awesome build here. If you built this in survival, show it to me and send me a picture on Twitter, and I will favorite it, because if you build this, I want to see it, because that is fantastic. This build has been in the works for over 2 months, and I finally finished it, and I don't have to touch it anymore. I was just going to look at it, and mega builds are tough. I like let's builds better, but like castles and stuff, it takes a while if you're doing a tutorial. Let's builds are fine, but because I don't have to do it over and over again. I don't have to make two castle manors or two castles if I'm making it. So, sneak peek to the next tutorial. It's gonna be this house, and you should stay tuned for that. Oh, I keep hitting my pop filter. Because it's gonna be dandy. We already have the first episode recorded, and that's gonna be it. So, thank you all for watching. 10 episodes of a mega tutorial. Holy crap. That took a while, huh? So, this is the successor to the Victorian mansion that I never finished. It looks just like it. So, and I never finished it. And this one I finished. Very proud of myself. So, thank you all for watching this Mega Build series. Mega Tutorial. This is not a Mega Build. Mega Tutorial series. It's now coming to a close. We're going to start up some Let's Builds instead of the Mega Tutorial. I'm going to try to do the Let's Builds and Tutorials at the same time. It's going to be tough. Plus, a potential new survival series on a server that I am not allowed to talk about yet. But, you know, you'll find out later. So, thank you all for watching. Stay fancy, my friends. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.